Uh-oh. There's a nice necklace of you over there.
Hey. Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana-flavored bag of expulsion in your pocket.
Oops.
Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage.
Well?
Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
You can't see that from the stage. We went in from the side. How about minor infractions?
How many minor infractions and a major one?
This is no joke, Miss Price.
Who's joking? You've seen my math grades.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use.
Oh, no,
you
no.
Blackwell has a zero-tolerance policy.
Don't be so hasty now, my good man.
And yet if my olfactory sense does not fail me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price?
Who talks like that? A search of your person?
That's what I thought.
Olfactory
senses? I'll look forward
senses?
To seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
Oh, do we want... This goes into the thing. We have to do the thing. We have to do the trading insult thing, right? I know you guys want to see it. It's a bad idea, but I know you guys want to see it.
Wells really has it out for me. I have to convince him it's in his best interest to back off.
Okay.
Actually, sir, I'm gonna go with no.
Ah. So you're going to mouth off to me now, yes? And here I thought your well of witticisms had finally run dry.
My well is deep?
Sir, my well of witticisms runs so deep that you would get trapped at the bottom and never make it out alive.
Mm.
Jokes? In my experience, that's how the guilty cover up their infractions.
The guilty have rights?
How did you become principal without learning the Constitution? The Fourth Amendment, illegal search and seizure?
Bingo.
We are a private institution, and policy allows me to search all students on the premises.
High-risk policy.
Is it also policy to label certain students high-risk and then single them out for special intimidation tactics?
How do you know about that designation?
That's
perhaps the better question you should be asking yourself is, what else do I know?
I'm sure we, do not need to make so public an issue of your behavior today.
Ah, now I see.
But make no mistake, Miss Price. This is not over.
Ooh, goody. I love cliffhangers. Funny, just a couple years ago, something like that would have scared the crap out of me. These days, I'm at, like, the collegiate level of not giving any fucks.
So funny. Do not walk on the stage. Oops.
Huh. Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage.
Could go sit on the crate again, but I don't think that would do anything. What are these papers all over the place? Principal Wells should leave me alone and focus on whoever's littering all over this campus. It's a travesty. Look at that.
This makes being high sound like a bad thing.
Arcadia Bay, fire danger rating today. Low, high, very high, severe, extreme, catastrophic. Fire danger rating? Okay. Oh, wildfire danger. And this is, what, info sheet? So I guess when she walks up to these things, maybe she was just talking about what's-her-name's DVD. Oh, that has the DVD again. Dangers of forest fires. Only you can prevent forest fires.
Heaven's work is actually pretty good. I'd never tell him that, of course.
By Evan Harris. Yeah, I didn't notice that. Oh, Victoria! Oh my God, Miss Freeze herself.
Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
But for some reason, we're gonna do that anyway. Talk. I mean, Carrie not Price. Vomit razor blades.
It's Chloe.
Oh right, I'm just teasing.
Sure you
People
are.
People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever.
Oh, nice
for
you.
But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Rachel Amber.
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
Yeah, we're lovers. We murdered a man. It was so choice.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Oh, thanks.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
You don't?
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're...
Late for chemistry.
Being you. Oh.
Sabotage her homework? I can't stand Victoria, and I'm, like, really curious of what that entails. So I'm gonna choose sabotage your homework. We're in for a major karma dump coming at us soon. I know it.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was...
She's taking notes.
Fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and, uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey! Thanks, Carrie.
Carrie. No problem.
Carrie. Yeah, swing those hips a little more. She's doomed. And so am I, probably, later.
The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole.
Yet it still needs excellence. So I'm purposely going to Stephanie last, just so I don't inadvertently trigger out some cutscene or something like that.
I can tell Justin's wearing his eau de gange.
I think I remember this guy from the first game.
Hey, price check. Gotten in any good trouble lately?
Price check. Let's ask about Rachel Amber.
Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
Blue hair is coming.
She's amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back.
Sounds good.
I was failing algebra. Hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
That's crushing it? Cloud of weed smoke?
Dude, you need to freshen like a mofo.
Are you saying I smell like weed?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Word. Well, good looking out, Price. Wanna hit?
Like, right here?
Or a hit of that.
Thanks.
That'll probably help later. I don't get to ask him about that other thing. What was the other thing?
There's my fellow high risk.
Chloe, what's the latest?
Oh, now I get to ask about crazy house party. Cool.
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like Meth Central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand. Alright, guess I'll see you in class.
Word.
I don't specifically remember like that much, but I think Max spent a lot of time trying to dodge Justin.
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Let's see who this girl is. Samantha. I don't remember a Samantha.
Samantha Myers, school wallflower. She could give you a run for your money, Max.
Hmm.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Hmm. I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
It's funny.
It's funny. The title's actually a play on the song, Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf?
And that's funny?
It is if you're the wolf.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
That makes two of us. I think I remember her, maybe, from a part of the campus that's like that way. In the area where we saw Katie fall.
Samantha Myers, school wallflower. She could give you a run for your money.
I really didn't mean anything.
Okay. It's just no one knows what you're talking about, including your own self. And me. So I don't want to inadvertently walk into the school without getting my DVD, so...
Steph and Mikey normally post up somewhere quiet in the courtyard.
Like over there? Probably. Let's see if there's anything else to discover or see. Oh, there's that one guy that hangs out over there. I think I remember him. It's like going back years later and... Yeah, Evan. The illustrator. Artist type. See the dorms.
No, Chloe. Class is back the other way.
I think we saw that girl at the dorms. Like I said, it's been a while since I played the first one. Evan!
Ah, Evan. Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What soapbox is he on today?
Let's find out.
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
That soapbox.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
Why are you doing this?
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess.
No idea. Wildfires are awesome anyway.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Oh, good grief.
Say knobcone again.
No.
I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. Anything to get out of class.
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
By napping?
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
Really sign it. I'm gonna really sign it.
There you go. Just don't expect this to become a habit. Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Oh my god. Big McHuge Balls, Principal Dix. Okay, mine's the only real name on there. Come exercise your democratic rights to assemble and discuss the importance of preventative fire safety to our fragile ecosystem.
What? Caring about important issues?
Caring in general.
Did you see those other two names, guy?
Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders. What's worse, a poser who cares about issues or no one caring at all?
You're back!
Why do I keep talking to you? I've got shit to do.
Poor guy. Wasn't he a lot cooler in the other game? I think so. Okay, there's what's her name. But stand by, guys. I'll be right back. Okay. Steph and Mikey.
Steph Gingrich and Mikey North, Blackwell's premier indoor kids. Steph has created something of a business selling pirated DVDs to other students.
Really? Well, it's obviously playing some kind of role-playing game there. She's got the screen there. It kind of looks like game... It looks like dungeon something.
Need my DVD cool. From Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Yeah, right here. I'm checking out their character sheets and stuff. Do you mind? God, I miss playing D&D. So much fun. Okay. Hey, got my DVD?
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I was literally thinking try me before it came up. Try me. Oh no. I used to play? I don't know if Chloe used to play, but I actually used to play, so I'm gonna say I used to play.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics.
Oh, for free.
You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel is a gamer?
Rachel Amber?
No idea.
You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
Well, what's it to you is really rude. Not like Chloe would be above being rude. We're not friends, I guess.
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
She does?
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
So we're gonna do? Play this? Sure.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Is that possible? Why is that funny? There's no such thing as an elf barbarian.
Are you insulting me in some obscure nerd way?
Think about it. An elf? Like, skinny and kind of weird, but also a barbarian, so, like, really angry.
In other words, Chloe Price.
What?
Wow, you two are a riot.
All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well.
Dun, dun, dun.
Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. Hmm. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you and greeting.
Cool story, bro.
I am Elamai, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
I am Daenerys Targaryen. How's it go? The unburnt, the broken of, the unburnt, the breaker of chains, the first of her name, who can remember all that? But definitely not Barb. And Chloe's pretty unimaginative, just call herself Chloe, so I am Calamastia. And I warn you not to trifle with me.
Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once made a man kebab. That is good, but I want to hear, according to my character sheet, I want to hear what she's going to say.
It says right here that I taught your precious King Tiberius everything he knows about fighting. So, Elamon, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
You gave her that, elf barbarian.
I did.
Elamon bows deeply. I've heard of you in the castle. King Tiberius owes you his life.
Damn right he does.
It's an honor to fight alongside you.
Damn straight.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie.
Nah.
Where do you wish to go?
Is this a trick question? Let's free the prisoners.
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages. Each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. Hmm. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
What?
Poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh,
draconians.
Okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
You don't have a knock spell? Intimidate him out of the cage? No, I don't know. I really like these sequences, so I'm going to probably choose as many of these as I like feel like I should. So, instead of tempting him with bread or picking a lock, intimidate?
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
Roll.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard?
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Alright.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
Let's go.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use-
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back.
She backs
his
off.
His scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Meat puppet.
I wiggle my hand. Hey, dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Awesome.
Neither do I.
The dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
Die of old age? Make you shorter.
You're short, I say. But you can always get shorter. Give me the key, or I'll chop off your legs and beat you to death with them.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body
into face.
So I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was
nuts. I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll.
Cool.
A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling,
what do we roll?
Hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Natural 20?
Yeah.
Go team. Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As on you it. Free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear.
Oh, jeez.
What's next?
I'm kind of liking this, so I want to, like, prolong it as much as possible. I would play a whole game like this. Seriously, this is awesome. Let's go to the training ground and see what loot we can get.
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points.
Cool.
There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay, maybe not cool.
So what do we do?
Gotta sleep.
Cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
I thought sleep spell, maybe.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs.
Yummy.
Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Mm, it smells like chicken.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Cool dice. Fatal cleave.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward
see her
with
hand.
Both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game!
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survives.
Nice going. Hey. What's your name? Oh, be nice. We all make mistakes. It's funny, you see on Chloe's hand it says get to chemistry class or go to chemistry class, something like that.
Don't worry, Elamon guy.
Elamon guy.
We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods. Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
Yeah, forget it. Now we go to the warlord's tent.
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well.
He's big.
Sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
See about that.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact.
Uh-oh.
Durgeron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Oops.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Oh, nice
except
going.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe.
Can't use it now, right?
What'll it be?
You can't use it now. Annihilation Strike sounds sweet, whatever that is. Yeah, you don't want to specialize in just fire spells, you know, that leaves you at a disadvantage when you can't use fire. Annihilation Strike. What that is, that sounds like the coolest thing.
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation Strike! That sounds boss as fuck!
It does, doesn't it?
One?
What?
That's bad, right?
No!
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal.
Damn it.
Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Don't roll a one.
Oh no.
What?
Three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs. Plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
What? Well, this game is awesome, and I'm sorry, too, a little bit, but...
This game is awesome!
My feet?
Durgeron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
We'll mend you later.
Shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgeron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp! Stomp! Stomp!
This is all my fault!
Do something!
Sort of. What should I do?
Kalamasti, you must do something. Dance? Should I dance? Is he even gonna notice me dancing? Is he gonna care I'm dancing and just kill Elamon? I'm gonna jump in front of Elamon.
Alright, jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Kalamastia.
Okay. Durgeron has now turned his attention toward you.
Come on, baby.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
What are we rolling?
Shit.
Evasion?
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgeron laughs as he impales you on his blade.
What?
Lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgeron lifts you higher into the air.
Yeah, rub it in.
It hurts like hell. What do you do?
You mean there is something I can do? I don't think I can reach his head. Let's swing for his arm.
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Yeah, it's the right arm.
Brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Come on.
20!
Sweet!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground,
you
conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgeron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Sweet. Damn, Elamon!
Durgeron is defeated, but your wounds were too great.
I die.
I'm afraid Kalamastia is dead.
Resurrection!
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
Ha.
That was fun.
You guys are cool.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Not bad.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game. nerds.
We have to insult them anyway as we leave.